Every day, you advance as a nation, which gets us closer to a more efficient nation. We often hear people talk about machines taking over cashiers, and soon, might even replace doctors. Even if I think this is a step in the right direction, it could damage society in unimaginable ways if we do not draw a line between what most of them are machines and what most of them are humans. Jobs that do not require any manager activity are perfect for machines, because although they can follow instructions very well, they will fail at coming up with new instructions by themselves. As you've probably seen, supercomputers like IBM Watson have been able to beat humans at games such as Jeopardy, because it can search through the air very quickly. But as you can show, most struggle with categories they previously did not know about. Aside from providing prime time entertainment, machines can help us make our life easier, more efficient. They can monitor taxes, organize inventory, and analyze data in seconds, outperforming humans in every aspect. Yet, one occupation machines will never be able to fulfill is being a teacher, because teachers need to come up with new ways to instruct their students, which requires something out of the box, or in this case, the motherboard. As humans, we often aim for efficiency and automation, but this could lead us in a very harmful direction. Here is where the 2008 Disney film WALL-E comes to mind. In WALL-E, the robots left to clean up the mess humans left behind. Long story short, he finds them living in a spaceship which has fully automated the human experience. He finds them rolling around in chairs, drinking milkshakes all day, and although that does sound pretty awesome, humanity would lose its purpose if we ended up like this. Direct human interaction would be completely erased from our lives, and in my opinion, there's something most magical about touching a human being. Connecting with others is a reason I mean. If we allow machines to make and do everything for us, we will lose that bond, and our existence will have no purpose. In other words, if technology is our only connection, it's like we are the cables, and they are the ones living our life. A way we connect with others is through the things they make. There's something about handmade products that makes it special. Even if they may have more flaws compared to those made by machines, knowing that another human has dedicated time to their craft and that this is a one-of-a-kind product is truly amazing. A clear example of this is handmade versus machine-made coffee. Even if the ingredients are the same, somehow when it's made by your abuela or somebody of significance, it will taste better than coffee made by a machine. Even though I personally do not drink coffee, I can see what people feel this way. This is what I call human magic, and it is extremely difficult to describe. I believe this holds true not only with food, but with anything made by human hands. It takes years to master a craft. Machines make the same coffee for everyone. When something is made from scratch, you do not only get the product, you get the maker's story. In one little piece of wood, metal, or whatever the material is, get the years of hard work, their passion, all encapsulated in one beautiful creation. Machines are not able to provide this most magical feeling. They lack the spark of creativity that us humans have, because we are driven by our soul. The machines we make will be what we make of them. It is crucial that we train these new inventions to aid us in the quest of discovery. But they must not guide us, because that is the soul's job. But I will admit, if it was not for technology, we would not be as advanced as we are. There are some things that humans just do not need to waste time on, such as making very sensitive calculations. We should use time wisely. We should just think creatively and analyze ideas. Let the machines do the hard work. As one of my teachers always says, work smarter, not harder. Before computers, scientists would spend hours making calculations. The more calculations they have to do, the more likely they were to make a mistake. And if you've ever taken a math class, you know it's true. Inventions like the log table, at this is which I will not claim right now because that requires a whole different talk, have been said to add many years to a science's life. And does not even compare to how much time computers take. It is key to find a balance between efficiency and a complete takeover. Because if we do not plan for the future, all work done by previous generations will be lost. Figuring out what is adequate for machines to do and what tasks must remain in human hands is the most important decision we make in human history. 57 years ago, President John F. Kennedy said to American people, "Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country." Now I want to say something similar to you. Ask not what technology can do for you, ask what you can do with that technology. Thank you.